Do you know, friends? Babies are born with 300 bones, but as adults, we have only 206. Guess what? A bone that is not connected to any joint, that's the hyoid bone. If we had heard that we had 12 ribs, there are some who have 13 ribs. Do you know that the teeth is more stronger than the bone? Do you know that the knee is the biggest joint in the body? The femur, the longest, and the staples, the smallest, that is in your ear. Namaste, friends. My name is Ritesh Patel and I'm a senior lecturer and senior teacher at YogaFX International Yoga Teacher Training Academy. But it seems I'm still a student learning and exploring as always. I'm really thrilled to be present you an excellent series of anatomy physiology lectures. Today, we are talking about the skeletal system. We really hope that you enjoy, and please feel free to keep sending your emails if you have any questions, and really looking forward to seeing you soon. Let's get started. The skeletal system. So what is the skeletal system? The human skeletal system consists of all of the bones, cartilage, tendon and ligaments in the body. Altogether, the skeleton makes up about 20% of a person's body weight. An adult's skeleton contains 206 bones. Children's skeleton actually contain more bones because some of them, including those of the skull, fuse together as they grow up. There are also some differences in the male and female skeleton. The male skeleton is usually longer and has a high bone mass. The female skeleton, on the other hand, has a broader pelvis to accommodate for pregnancy and childbirth. Our skeletal system is a series of long and short bones connected to each other by joints. Our body depends on this skeletal framework for shape and movement. Without it, we would be like a jellyfish, soft and shapeless. Bone. The 206 bone which make up the human skeleton also have many other functions. They protect the softer part of the body like the heart, the brain, the lungs. Blood cells are produced in the bone marrow and the bones store many minerals like calcium and phosphorus. Although our bones are very hard on the outside, on the inside they are much softer, porous and sponge-like. Bones, like the rest of our body, are living tissues which are growing and reshaping themselves over and over again according to the way we use our bodies. Yoga poses bring a steady supply of blood, nutrients and energy to this mass of living, breathing, changing tissues. Regardless of age or sex, the skeletal system can be broken down into two parts, known as the axial skeleton and the appendicular skeleton. Axial skeletal anatomy. The adult axial skeleton consists of 80 bones. It's made of the bones that form the vertical axis of the body, such as the bones of the head, neck, chest and spine. Skull bones. The adult skull comprises 22 bones. These bones can be further classified by location, cranial bones. The 8 cranial bones form the bulk of your skull. They help to protect your brain. Facial bones. There are 14 facial bones. They are found on the front of the skull and make up the face. Vertebral column. The vertebral column is made of 26 bones. The first 24 are all vertebrae, followed by the sacrum and the coccyx, that is also known as your tailbone. The 24 vertebrae can be further divided into the cervical vertebrae, cervical vertebrae. There are 7 cervical vertebrae labeled C1 to C7, form the cervical spine, from the base of the skull down to the shoulders. At each level, the cervical vertebrae protects the spinal cord and work with muscles, tendons, ligaments, and joints to provide a combination of support structure and flexibility to the neck. There are some differences among the cervical vertebrae. The vertebrae at the top of the neck tend to be smaller and more mobile, while the lower cervical vertebrae are larger to handle great loads from the neck and head above. Cervical vertebrae C3 to C6 are known as typical vertebrae because they share the same basic characteristic with most of the vertebrae throughout the rest of the spine. C1 and C2 are considered a typical vertebrae because they have some distinguishing feature compared to the rest of the cervical spine. C1 vertebrae, that is the atlas, the top vertebrae called the atlas, is the only cervical vertebrae without a vertebral body. Instead, it is shaped more like a ring. The atlas connects to the occipital bone above to the support the base of the skull and form the atlanto-occipital joint. More of the head's forward-backward range of the motion occurs at this joint compared to any other spinal joint. C2 vertebrae, that is the axis. The second vertebrae, called the axis, has a large bony protrusion that is known as the odontoid process that points up from its vertebral body and fits into that ring-shaped atlas above it. The atlas is able to rotate around that axis, forming the atlanto-axial joint. More rotation range of motion occurs at this joint compared to any other, with some estimates being that nearly half of the head rotation occurs at this joint. While C1 and C2 are the smallest of the cervical vertebrae, they are also the most mobile. The thoracic cage is made up of the sternum, that is the breastbone, and 12 pairs of ribs, that is T1 to T12. These bones form a protective cage around the organs of the upper torso, including the heart and lungs. Some of the ribs attach directly to the sternum, while others are linked to the sternum via a cartilage. Some have no attachment point and are referred to as floating ribs. The thoracic spine begins below the cervical spine, that is C7 neck, roughly at the shoulder level, and continues downwards until it reaches the first level of the low back, that is your L1 lumbar spine. 12 vertebrae numbered T1 through T12 from top to bottom makes up the thoracic spine. When viewed from the side, a normal forward curvature called kyphosis, a kyphotic curve, is seen. Because the rib attached to the thoracic spine's vertebrae, this section of the spine is strong and stabilizing, with less range of motion than the cervical neck, that is, the neck region. Now, let us talk about the lumbar, that is the lower back. 5 vertebrae, that is L1 to L5, make up the lower part of the spine, which progressively increases in size going down to the lumbar back. Your lumbar spine supports the upper part of the spine. It connects to the pelvis and bears most of your body weight, as well as the stress of lifting and carrying items. Many back problems occur in the lumbar spine. The lumbar spine bends inward to create a C shape, that is known as a lordotic curve. The lumbar spine contains a total of 5 intervertebral discs situated between the vertebral bodies. The primary function of these discs are to first distribute compressive loads placed on the spine, providing shock absorption properties, maintain the distance between the vertebral bodies during movement, provide flexibility to the spine and prevent excessive movements, create and maintain the lordotic, that is backward C-shaped curve of the lumbar spine. Let us talk about the characteristic of the lumbar disc. The lumbar intervertebral disc have the following distinguishing features. size. The lumbar intervertebral disc are the thickest compared to the other spinal regions. The discs are also thicker in front than the back. Height. The lumbar disc becomes shorter during day due to the weight of the upper body. It is estimated that sleeping for a minimum of 5 hours helps the disc regain their original shape. The shape, the form of the lumbar disc changes with movement when the spine bends forward. The height in the front of the disc decreases, while the posterior height increases. The opposite occurs while bending backward. Now, let us talk about the sacrum. The sacral region is at the bottom of the spine and lies between the fifth segment of the lumbar spine and the coccyx, that is also known as your tailbone. The sacrum is a triangular shaped bone and consists of 5 segments, that is known as S1 to S5, that are fused together. A healthy sacral region is rarely fractured, except in instances of serious injury, such as a fall or trauma to the area. However, patients with osteoporosis or rheumatoid arthritis are inclined to develop stress fractures and fatigue fractures in the sacrum. Back pain or leg pain. Sciatica can typically arise due to injury when the lumbar spine and the sacral region connect, that is L5 and S1. Because this section of the spine is subjected to a large amount of stress and twisting during certain activities, just as sports and sitting for a long period of time. Let us talk about the coccyx, that is also known as the tailbone. The coccyx is located at the base of the spine and is composed of 4 vertebrae. Unlike the individual vertebrae in other regions of the spine, the vertebrae in the sacral region as well as in the coccyx are fused. Ligaments attach to the coccyx to the sacral hiatus at the synovial sacrococcygeal joint. When sitting, the coccyx shifts forward and acts as a shock absorber. However, falling on the tailbone or even such as childbirth can lead to coccygeal pain, known as coccydynia. In most cases, the pain is caused by an unstable coccyx, which results in chronic inflammation of the sacrococcygeal joint. So friends, here we finish the axial skeletal system. We really hope that you enjoyed it, and please feel free to send any questions that you may have. Stay tuned for the second part of the appendicular skeletal system. See you soon. Take care, keep smiling. Namaste.